deeper into the coalition talks. But from the ultra-Orthodox perspective, we have Rabbi Dov Halbertal, the former head of the office of the Chief Rabbi of Israel. Thanks for joining us. Now, you know, Netanyahu is pushing for a unity government that will include both the Haredim, the religious, and the blue and white party. But is that even feasible?
Yeah, why not? Why not? You have to know that for the religious, even the ultra-Orthodox, there is no problem to be even with the Arabs. I mean, not moral problem, not a religious problem, only a practical problem. There's no, we can sit with everybody.
Well, polls,
we need budgets,
right,
that's all.
But polls have come out saying that about 60%, almost 70% of the Israeli public wants a more secular government, right? So the question is, if there is a compromise that can be made between Kahol and Levan, the blue and white party, and the religious parties, especially when it comes to issues like civil marriage, public transportation on Shabbat, etc.
Military enlistment.
No, they will not accept. I mean, there can be a good idea to solve everything that's happening today. What's the idea? I don't know if people know it. The idea is, you know, the blue and white, they have 44 mandates, and the ultra-Orthodox have 17. Let's combine them together and come to a coalition. The blue and, you know, the both, Kahol Levan and the
Ultra-Orthodox.
Why not? Why not? So there will not be
civil marriage. They would never compromise on that issue?
Then, no, not. If they will have a political power, they will never compromise in it, if they will have a power. If they will be out of the power, like you said before, that maybe a lot of the people here want it, the non-religious, so maybe there will be, I'm not sure even then, but maybe there will be, because you have to know that very many people here in Israel are traditional. They know to appreciate the religious marriage.
But I think one of the biggest issues for the secular, who are, you know, the 69%, is that the religious aspect is legislated. So, for example, with driving and public transportation on the Shabbat, is that not something that could be compromised on, where the religious could simply not ride on the bus?
And let everybody else do what they want.
No, I don't see. Maybe it can be a very, you know, a small compromise, maybe in some very specific places, and that, but not altogether. Because, you know, it doesn't disturb me that there is a transportation here in Tel Aviv. I'm not living here. But it disturbs me as a Jew, as a part of a citizen in a Jewish state.
But if you're saying 70% of the Jewish population here saying, actually, we want public transportation on weekends, and we want the ultra-Orthodox to be drafted into the military, and we want civil marriage, then, I mean, they're Jews as well, right? So where do they fall?
Yeah, no, there is a big difference. It has to be understood. A big difference in between, you know, drafting to the army. That means that they want me to be... And it will never be in the ultra-Orthodox. It will never be, because that hurts the DNA of the ultra-Orthodox.
Why not?
But
why not? Why should
transportation
other Jews
is another
to...
issue. It's a different issue. Why not? What?
Why would the seculars join while the Haredim don't?
Have to go into the army
No. That's a big issue. That's a big question.
We can discuss it in one hour.
In short. The question is, what is the real burden here in the state of Israel and altogether to the Jewish people all over the world? What is the real burden? The non-religious people see that as the army, and they are right. You know, the army is a very big and very severe burden, and you know, it's a question of life and death and everything on one end. On the other end, the ultra-Orthodox, they think and they believe it in seriously. It's not, you know, that the main burden here is to keep the Jewish identity of the Jewish people here in Israel and altogether in all over the world. Keeping the Jewish identity means in only one way, sitting in the yeshivot and studying, not going to the army. Going to the army means ruining the yeshiva world.
All right, well, I think that the hope here is that there will be a unity that is able to kind of incorporate the desires of every Jew in this country, whether or not they're Orthodox or secular. Thank you so much for joining us, Dov.
Thank you.